Hey YouTube, Sougan Shobi here with a review of the Buster Gear Series 03 Sougan Blade. Sougan comes from the word Sougankyo, I believe, which is basically the word for binoculars. And since they are binoculars, as you can see right here, that makes sense. It's a pair of binoculars that transforms into a blade-ish thing. I'll get to that later. Box art here, pretty cool. 03 Sougan Blade. Really love this picture up here that they've used for the Buster Gear series. Really cool wallpaper material right here if people want to get on that. Right here it says Sougan Blade in English. Right down there, Sougan Blade. Kind of looks like Sokan, but then I see the little line and I'm like, oh, there's a G there. So really cool. On the back here it just shows all the stuff that it can do and the combination, which we'll get to. It does have a phrase for each Buddyroid. They list them out right here. They also list them in the instructions. As of the recording right now, I do not know exactly what they say, but I will put them in the up here in the little text like I always do for my reviews. So no need to fret. I will cover that. You just need to read. So here we have the Sougan Blade in the binoculars mode. So I'll go ahead and plot that down right here while we take a look. So they got the lenses up here, there's the trigger right there, there's a button right up here that activates the little flippy lens, there's a screen back here, and right here is where the blade is. So it kind of makes that lens look really goofy. Go Buster logo right there, and all in all, really, really cool. So take a look at the screen right here, it's just kind of a little scope-like thing, showing you that he's staring at a building. Maybe he had a person, I don't know. Right here is where you would look through if these were an actual pair of binoculars. Right here is where the connection piece for the Ichigan Buster is. But anyway, you press this button right up here and... oh, it pops up. Cool. If you just kind of press it, it generally kind of gets stuck. I don't know if that's just mine or whether that's a full factory thing. But if you just kind of press it, it doesn't work all the way. So you have to hold it down until it pops all the way out. Really cool. So the on and off switch is somewhere. It's right here. Get the turn on noise. You betcha. So, anyway, it just cycles through those. Yep, so when you press this button, the little light pops up. Nothing happens after that. But now, when you press the trigger... you get a light up here, plus a little... zoomy noise. I don't really know why the binoculars have a light on them, but I guess it helps them see in the dark or something like that. I don't know. But overall, just a really, really cool look in the binoculars mode. I personally really dig it. So to get to the Sougan Blade mode, you press this down here, and this part will just come out straight and activate the transformation noise. This one's a little bit different. You press it down and click it over, and it'll lock here at first. Hold it down and then click it all the way straight, because it needs to be bent for the combination. Fold the blade out, and here you have the Sougan Blade in blade mode. It's pretty much your standard crappy roleplay sword toy. It's 15 inches long, actually. Take that as you will. The one in the show really isn't all that big either. The blade is probably only about twice the size of this, so it is pretty pathetic. I'm on here, it does say Mode 001 Binoculars. That's cool. So yeah, it's really nothing really all that great. The handle's a decent size for my hand. If you've got bigger hands, it probably won't be. This should be closed when you do it, by the way. But anyway, when it's all closed like this, you get this sound. You do get a light right there, but it's technically not supposed to be seen, but whatever. One noise, nothing really all that spectacular. When you press the button down, So then the sword would go green and you're like, yeah, and stuff. Pull the trigger. And then the Metroid would explode. And then you just repeat the sound when you pull the trigger again. Nothing all that spectacular there as well. So what we're going to do here is combine this thing with the Ichigan Buster to make the Ichigan Buster Special Buster Mode. Lots of busters here. So fold that, and then fold this one down a notch, and then fold this one up a notch. So it looks like this. Take the Ichigan Buster, and as I've shown in that review, pop off the lens, just like that, and then line this up with this peg, and then line this top part off with the place where you would put, it's the hot shoe, I believe, and just go like that.
It's time for Special Buster.
And it's time for Special Buster. You got lights coming out of who knows where. That's so keep playing. Pull the trigger. And so you get that kind of fiery noise. Let me see if I can stand this up straight. Take it back a little. There is the Buster in the combined mode. All in all, it's okay. I'll just say that it's okay. I don't like this gap that's created right here, but I do like the fact that it does act as a cool scope for the Ichigan Buster. I think that in all is pretty cool. Obviously, there's like no sort of scope up here to actually replicate the whole scope idea, but the thought's there, and that's what counts, I suppose. But it's not too bad, it's just not my favorite looking weapon combination ever. But the fact that it does combine is cool, and like we mentioned in the Ichigan Buster review, there will be more things that can attach to this, potentially other toys that the Sougan Blade can attach to. So there is a lot of compatibility here with the Buster gear line. So now we are back in the binoculars mode. Let's go ahead and put that down. Bring back our turntable. Stick that right there. And there we go. So I personally think it's a fairly decent toy. I think the Ichigan Buster is a lot better of a toy. But when you look at it from the perspective that the Sougan Blade is more or less a side weapon, while the Ichigan Buster is the main weapon that's probably going to be used for all of the combinations with the various weapons and gear throughout the show. So when you look at it from that perspective, it's obvious that the Ichigan Buster is going to get more sounds, a cooler feature overall. And the fact that this was a sword toy kind of killed it in the first place anyway. Another thing I found kind of gripey is the fact that when you look at this box, how it's a very long, long box, and the fact that they could have just packed it in a pretty compact square box in binoculars mode, but they chose to make it longer. I think Bandai's deliberately making packages huge to kind of kill foreign importers. No, I'm kidding. It's, I think, just because the box of the Ichigan Buster was kind of square, they didn't want another square box, so they made a long rectangular box instead. But I don't know, they could have made the package for this thing pretty small and pretty economical, but instead they went with the big one. But that's not great with the toy at all, by any means. I like the Buddyroid phrases, that's cool. The sounds are pretty cool as well, and like I said, the combination is pretty neat. I was only planning on getting the Ichigan Buster, but then I decided to pick this up, one, because it was the only toy I wouldn't have, and two, it's got a combination, so that kind of suckers me into buying more things. I like it. If you're a fan of the overall look and like sword weapons, then by all means, pick it up. If you're being kind of more frugal with your purchases, this is a pretty easy pass. It just doesn't have that much sounds compared to the Ichigan Buster, and personally, it's just not that good of a weapon compared to the Ichigan Buster. So overall, I can recommend it. It's just not really up there on the oh my god, buy this list. So you can check out shukenshinobi.com for all these updates on my reviews and hauls, and of course, check out ridersrangersandrambles.com, bringing you the latest toku news in the craziest way possible. So take care and have a great one. Bye.